Hi everyone, it's Galina. For today's card, I'm going to use this beautiful stamp with gifts. It calls lots of gift trimmings, and it consists of two large stamps, which you can use as border stamps or to create fun party backgrounds. Also, I will use this half-striped cover die. It's actually a set of two dies, one bigger die for backgrounds and one to create in labels or sharker elements on your cards. So I'm starting with cutting out my card background from regular white cardstock, and I'm keeping this large inner element from the die cut. And here I have my Misty stamping tool, and I'm positioning my first stamp on it. Because I'm going to color all these gifts with Copic markers, I will use Copic friendly black ink. My favorite ink is Nuvo Hybrid ink. I press the lid, and here are my first gift boxes. Next, I'm going to use second stamp to create a full background with gifts. I repeat stamping two times to get nice crisp outlines. To color all my gift boxes, I choose some bright colors of Copic markers. At first, I thought to choose a rainbow color palette, but then I decided to use a little less colors and make some sort of a new color palette. I'm going to make a simple one-layer coloring on each of the boxes. To make it easier to maintain the balance of all the shades on the background, I start coloring with only one color. I add a red color to the selected elements of the image and try to make the red elements not too close to each other. I repeat this step with the following marker colors. Next, I color all the yellow elements, then green, blue, and so on. After my coloring is done, I'm going to pick some matching cardstock for my card. I have a lot of scraps in my stash, so it was easy. With the cover plate die, I cut out a stripe from each piece of the cardstock. Now let's move to my favorite technique, inlay die cutting, with which you can create beautiful one-layered designs. At first, I'm adding the main white die cut on the card base. Next, I'm adhering colored piece inside of the white die cut. In this step, I'm using liquid glue from Studio Katya. This glue gives me a few extra seconds to move the die cut before it will be sticked. Next, I'm adding all the stripes into the gaps in the main white die cut. It's a fun process, like assembling a puzzle on the card. Using smaller die from the set, I cut out a white label and a frame from the gold glitter cardstock. On the white label, I'm going to stamp a sentiment. I'm going to combine two stamps from different sets to create a birthday sentiment. I pick up a first stamp with the acrylic block. It has small marks, so it's easy to line up a stamp. First phrase, I stamp it with a blue ink and second with a bright red ink. For the sentiment, I choose the colors from the color palette of my card. I foam mount the label with the sentiment on the card and add a glitter frame, and my card is done. Don't forget to visit Studio Katya blog. All links and supply lists you can find in the video description below. See you soon. Bye!